Plants grow very quickly after applying liquid organic fertilizer. Plus 5. Listen, plants that grow very quickly after applying liquid organic fertilizer usually indicate that the fertilizer is of good quality and the plants are responding positively to the available nutrients, especially if the formula is balanced. Several factors that may contribute to rapid growth include balanced nutrient content. Effective POC contains macronutrients, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and micronutrients in a form that is easily absorbed by plant roots. Microorganism activity. Liquid organic fertilizers are often rich in beneficial microorganisms that help improve soil health and nutrient uptake efficiency. Improved soil structure. Regular application of POC can improve soil structure, allowing for better aeration and water retention. Utilizing kitchen waste for fertilizer can be done by processing it into compost or organic liquid fertilizer, POC, using materials such as vegetable scraps, fruit peels, banana, egg, coffee, tea grounds, and rice washing water, which are rich in nutrients such as nitrogen, potassium, calcium, and microelements, to fertilize the soil and strengthen plants naturally. The method can be done using the compost method by mixing organic materials with soil, or fermentation for POC, making it an economical and environmentally friendly solution to reduce waste and meet plant nutritional needs. To make liquid organic fertilizer, POC, from coffee grounds, simply soak the grounds in water. About 5 tablespoons of coffee grounds or 2 cups per 1 liter per gallon of water. Let it sit overnight or for 12 hours, then strain to create a nutrient solution that's ready to be sprayed or watered on plants, promoting better growth due to its nitrogen content. Materials and tools. Coffee grounds, used for brewing, water bucket or container strainer, gauze or fine sieve, spray bottle, optional. Mix. Place the coffee grounds in a bucket, then pour in water, about 5 tablespoons of grounds per 1 liter of water, or 2 cups per 5 gallons of water, stir well. Let it sit. Let the mixture sit for at least 12 hours or overnight to allow the nutrients from the coffee grounds to dissolve into the water. Strain. Strain the solution to separate the grounds from the water. The remaining liquid is the liquid solution. Coffee grounds are rich in nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, magnesium, and calcium, which are beneficial for plants. Using this fertilizer can boost plant growth and enrich the soil. Dried coffee grounds can also be sprinkled directly onto the soil or mixed with compost. The ideal time to apply liquid coffee grounds fertilizer is in the morning, before 9 a.m., or afternoon, after 4 p.m., to prevent evaporation and avoid direct sunlight. For coffee plants in general, apply twice a year, at the beginning and end of the rainy season. But for coffee grounds POC, spraying can be more frequent, every 2 weeks, sprayed under the leaves or around the roots when the plants have started to grow, not when the seedlings are very young. Application time details. Daily time. Morning, 6 o'clock to 9 a.m., or afternoon, 3 o'clock to 6 p.m., are the best times to maximize nutrient absorption by plants without evaporation or loss. Frequency. Generally, twice a year, at the beginning and end of the rainy season, for routine fertilization, but can be applied more frequently during periods of heavy rainfall to prevent fertilizer leaching. For coffee grounds fertilizer, when ready, can be applied 3 to 5 times at 2-week intervals, or regularly twice a week depending on the plant's needs. Plant phase. Avoid direct application to very young seedlings. 1 to 2 weeks after planting, as young roots are not yet ready to absorb nutrients, it is best to apply when the plant is entering its active growth phase. Application method. Foliar spraying. Spray onto the undersides of leaves, canopy, in the morning or evening. Root watering. Apply in a circular furrow approximately 30 to 40 centimeters from the trunk and to a depth of 2 to 5 centimeters, or directly onto the planting medium, compost once it has decomposed. Types of plants suitable for liquid organic fertilizer. Vegetables and fruits, tomatoes, cucumbers, melons, watermelons, spinach, kale, cabbage, chili peppers. Horticultural and ornamental plants. Strawberries, orchids, low concentrations, hydroponic plants, and perennials such as durian and avocado, for the generative phase. Coffee grounds mixed with soil plus 9. Listen, coffee grounds mixed with soil are very beneficial for fertilizing plants because they are rich in nitrogen, potassium, and phosphorus, improve soil structure, and help repel pests like snails. Mixing the grounds directly into the soil, sprinkled and covered with a little soil, composting them, or making a liquid fertilizer can support earthworms and provide healthy organic nutrients, ideal for acid-loving plants like azaleas. Benefits of coffee grounds for soil and plants. Adds nutrients. A good source of nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium for plants. Improves soil structure. Improves drainage, aeration, and air retention. Natural fertilizer. Makes excellent compost or can be sprinkled directly into the soil. Pest repellent. Its abrasive properties and caffeine can deter slugs and ants. Attracts earthworms. Earthworms love coffee grounds, helping to enrich the soil. Acidity regulator. Increases soil acidity, suitable for plants that prefer acidic conditions. Direct application. Sprinkle a thin layer on the surface of the soil around the plant, then cover with a light layer of soil. About 0.5 centimeters. Compost. Mix with other compost ingredients to enrich the compost. Liquid fertilizer. Mix 2 cups of coffee grounds with 5 gallons of water, steep overnight, then use to water or spray the leaves. Warning. Don't overdo it, as the temperature can be detrimental to the worms. About half a teaspoon per container once a week is enough to feed the worms. After giving coffee grounds, the plants experience a process of releasing nutrients such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium slowly, which increases soil fertility, stimulates root and vegetative growth, leaves, stems, and improves soil structure, although it needs to be processed first, dried, made into compost, POC, so that it does not clump and impede water, and balances it with carbon-rich materials, dry leaves. Processes that occur in the soil. Decomposition. Microorganisms begin to break down the coffee grounds, releasing the nutrients they contain. This process is faster if the grounds are mixed with other compost materials, dried leaves, grass, nitrogen release. Coffee grounds are rich in nitrogen, the green material, which is gradually released as they decompose, supporting vegetative plant growth, leaves and stems. CEC increase. Increases the soil's cation exchange capacity, CEC, making it better able to store and provide essential nutrients, such as calcium and magnesium, to plants. Earthworm interaction. Earthworms love coffee grounds, aiding the decomposition process and further enriching the soil. Pest repellent. The caffeine and abrasive properties of coffee grounds help repel pests like slugs. Organic fertilizers make plants fertile because they improve soil structure, increase air holding capacity, and provide macro-micronutrients gradually, thus encouraging stronger root growth, greener leaves due to nitrogen, and increasing resistance to pests, resulting in healthier, more uniform plants and more optimal harvests. The effects are clearly visible with increased vegetative growth, such as more branches and shoots, as well as plants that are more resistant to disease and produce better quality harvests in the long term.